And now, how excited am I? I'm here with a young actor who I think is simply one of the best actors of his generation, and I'm happy to say we're friends, and I've known him for quite a while, and everything I've seen him in, he's totally blown me away. It's Michael Aronov. Hey, Michael. Finally, we get here. Oh, my God, your hands are freezing. Is it cold outside?
That's all good. It's nice and warm here, though.
Yes, we're at Le Veau d'Or. You know, this is where, like, Orson Welles always sat at this table.
Really?
By himself. I guess he could fit here. And Ernest Hemingway used to sit over there, and Grace Kelly used to sit over there. And
wow.
It's a historic place.
I love it.
But you're making history, young sir, with your brilliant show, Manigma, which is now off-Broadway at the Harold Clurman, is that right?
That's
on
right.
42nd Street. Yeah. And it's a one-man show. Michael is the only person in the show, and you hold the audience in the palm of your charismatic hands for how long? How is it?
It's about an 80-minute show. 80 minutes, yeah.
Extraordinary. Yeah. Well, Michael, you talk. I'm just sitting here praising you. So.
Thank you, Stephen. No, I'm happy you came the other night. I was always the genesis of this project.
And I saw you before, too, back
4 years ago.
I guess it's impossible.
Yeah, we did this piece several years ago. It was kind of a big hit then. By the end of it, we were selling out completely. Had to turn people away by the towards the end of the run. So producers came to me, wanted to put this up off Broadway in a nice venue, Harold Clurman Theater, and I said, why not?
4 years.
4 years ago.
Trying
yeah.
to get it on. Wow.
Yeah, yeah. And I've been busy.
Oh yes, you've
doing
been
my
in
own work.
Spain.
Yeah,
happened.
Spain.
I
yeah,
know.
And then I was just came back from Germany doing Streetcar. For 3 months and
playing, I guess, Stanley
guest, yeah.
Wild guest, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I kind of wanted to take a break from theater for a little while after this experience in Europe because I was a little beat down, just
really
physically, emotionally.
Were
everything.
You doing it's, it in English?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
I was doing it in English, and it's an extraordinary, obviously, an extraordinary piece. And Tennessee is kind of as good as it gets, and he merges this kind of fantastic idea of lyrical and visceral, which I think is
yes, he does.
Is an extraordinary combination for a playwright. And people
and you write, now the thing is, we have to keep talking about Manigma. I'm going to keep repeating that name over and over again, if you won't, because you wrote it.
Yeah.
Too.
Yeah.
What was the genesis of your writing it?
Well, I've always been drawn to polarities. Like my dad is a rough and rugged kind of guy, old school.
I met him.
Yeah, kind of Eastern European.
I knew he was your father.
Yeah, yeah. Very stoic and powerful and, you know, has a lot of weight and energy to him. And then seeing a man like that completely break down when his mother passed away. I don't think I've ever really seen him cry, you know.
Wow.
And seeing that was such a powerful kind of eye-opening experience. And that mixture of strength and weakness has always been, I don't know, kind of captivating to me. Also, you find the, you know, the weak introverts who turn into the warrior out of nowhere, and I guess I was trying to write a play about that because I feel like a lot of that coexists in myself. Because
had
I,
you written something before? Or was this
I've
your
been,
first play?
Yeah, I've been writing a lot. I wrote a full-length script called Sea Guts, Manigma. I've written some features. But this was kind of the first baby for me. So I wanted to focus on that, focus on all the things that I grew up kind of experiencing, having a rough, kind of rugged early life in Miami, hanging out with troublemakers and doing kind of all kinds of bad things for a young guy. I feel like I grew up faster than I wanted to. But at the same time, graduated high school with like a 4.2 grade point average, was always writing poetry and getting great grades, and was always big on family. So this kind of duality was coexisting in my belly from the get-go. To this day, I feel like a raging kind of anarchist maniac a lot of the times, and other days I feel like Mother Teresa. So I tried to create a project that exemplifies these diversities, these kind of disparate qualities.
Because you play basically six characters in Manigma. Mm-hmm. Do you want to discuss them?
Yeah,
or,
yeah. And
or let it be a surprise for the audience when they see what you're doing.
I won't get too much into detail, but I wanted all six of these people to be based on a component that lives kind of loudly in me.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, so we have the artist, Cha-Cha, who is the...
Right, we won't tell you what Cha-Cha is an artist of, that just that he, she exists,
yeah,
yes.
He, she exists, and she represents
that's
the
artist. That's the biggest shock, I think, the right at the beginning of the play, I'm like, oh my god!
Exactly, I opened the show with that because I want to kind of knock people in the mouth with it
I can talk about this without giving anything away. The first moments of the play, and I don't remember if it started this way before, is the lighting went bang, 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 and was sort of driving you out of your mind, and like you were didn't know which particular area of the stage, because he's the only one in it, you were going to go to, and I thought, does he change this every night and just start with a different character depending on? But I guess not.
No.
It was very dramatic. I loved it.
I like that too, because
did you do that before?
Yeah, I did.
You did. Okay.
Not as much. I mean, it's a different kind of lighting design.
Yeah. The lighting is very present in this production of Manigma at the Harold Clarman Theater off Broadway,
and I wanted all these characters to be alive and dangerous and hilarious and flawed and pure and kind of I wanted people to empathize and sympathize with them, because these are all elements of me that I kind of flourished into an entire story, from the artist to the wild rebel to
A guy in a workout room.
Yeah,
who represents... I see Michael often in the gym, but anyway, we won't say where.
Yeah, and that guy represents.
You've been built up. Your arms are really out there.
It depends
there,
on what show I'm working on. If you get beef it up for a show, I'll do that. For Stanley, especially.
For Stanley, is that what you did?
Yeah. That's why I wanted to take a break after that run. I was kind of worn out emotionally, physically. I wanted to take a break, but then this came my way, and I'd be an idiot not to jump at it. But, so all six of these guys, I wanted them to be as polar from one another as possible, but also very true. People relate to them so much. Every night we have different people who kind of correspond to different...
I would imagine,
characters, and I love that, because some people are really drawn to the introvert on the toilet, who's very obsessive-compulsive and misses his mother, and, there's something about that guy that resonates with people very much. And he's quiet and into himself and searching and desperate for sleep, something that I struggle with in my life, having trouble to find kind of peace to chill out my brain a little bit. And then the person immediately after that is this kind of raging animal who's locked up in prison, who's kind of annihilates and obliterates everybody. And he represents the rage and hostility that I think that kind of blares in my belly. But also, once again, he's coming from a place of hurt, of pain, of aching because of the loss of his sister. So all of these guys are trying to tell the story and allowing the audience to learn from their experiences. And it's not pedantic, which I think a solo show can be, patronizing and like, listen to what I've been through, I want you to learn from this.
Well, it doesn't seem like your experience, it seems like characterizations, you know? It doesn't seem like it's an autobiographical thing, which is interesting, which is, I like that, because it's like, who is this guy? What is he representing here?